Sky is so high, if you don't know how to fly, aim for laser to make you fly. Sky is so high, if you don't know how to fly, aim for laser to make you
fly. A private company, though it is also a part of Air India, is registered as a private company, and we take care of the ground. When Air India started, the new civil aviation policy which has come into force during the last 5 to 10 years, year over year, only in India, among all the airlines. So this being the scenario, the growth and also the people, the employment opportunities and also related services also have improved a lot. Keeping this in mind, now Air India was not a ground handling company, it was like any other airline, wholly owned by the government. Now what happened, a lot of agencies, ground handling agencies have started. Air India also, it's a joint venture company with Singapore Air Terminal Services. They have 50-50, but this is a separate company by itself, doing ground handling services in 5 metro cities. One is Hyderabad, Bangalore, Delhi, Trivandrum and Mangalore. We are operating in 5 stations as a ground handling company, which will grow in the years to come. Why you want to join the aviation? Many a times I ask some. I find a lot of students who have done BTEC, BE and all that, they come. What's the aviation? Why you want to join aviation? There will be usually asked to answer like, okay, my parents want me to do BTEC, my parents want me to do BE, that's how I've done, but I have a fancy for aviation. And many of them I find always say that it's a glamour. It's like a glamour, you know, which is not there in reality. Once you join, the glamour goes. You know the hard realities when you start working. It appears to be glamorous, working in an airport, wearing a uniform, working for an international airline. It's certainly a pride, but it doesn't. It also comes with a price. The sheer hard work. People don't survive after a couple of years. It's 10 hours work. You have to stand 6 to 8 hours. It's not all that easy. But the returns and also the... It's not like that, no, many times, no, just okay. I want to become an air hostess. I want to become a flight officer. You come motivated and then you come and they get disappointed when they join the ground handling service. So you have to make up your mind. Many a times I tell them, when I do interview, I not only do interview for the sake of my company, I also become an advisor. Nowadays I have interviewed more than 5,000 candidates in the last 6 years. It takes a couple of minutes for me, I know whether they fit into it or not. And I also, nowadays, make it a point to advise you what is best for you. It's not that, you know, many times, you know, we just carried away by your friends or by your colleagues or by advertisements, by seeing this. You know, people have talent in some other thing also, you just walk into this company and then they get disappointed, disillusioned and then they leave. That will know your career is lost, your precious time is lost. This is a crucial time of your life where you make a career, you build a career. If you don't do that, will be wasting and switching over. I think people switching over from technical to non-technical, from then software company, then working in call centers, then come back. Typically, you know what is your target. It may take, for some people, it may take a couple of years, some people, it may take more time. But once your target is set, then you know, you will go towards the target. If your ambition and if your target is not clear, what do you want to become and how do you want to. But real work is totally different from what. See, you will learn grooming, you will know how to handle the customers, what to do, what not to do. All those things, you might have learned during, what's the course duration?
Maybe it's 3 years, 1 year. Huh? So
1 year.
1 year, they get the experience. Okay. So second and third year, only book studies.
Okay. So during the course of study is different from what. When you start working in the airport, it's totally a different scenario. It takes 1 year for us to, for the first couple of months we will be doing only job walking to understand the topography of the airport. You make the best of the airlines. We are having Emirates, Cathay Pacific, Thai, Silkair, Saudi, Etihad, and besides Air India. So all the major airlines are being added by this organization, and the requirement for each airline is totally different. Each airline will have different standards. They have their own different way of handling the passengers. They have their own way of handling various activities related to that airline. So you have to get molded to that airline's requirements. So it is not common for all the airlines, you know, you just walk in, you do it. There are schemes, there are various.
All the students here are prepared to work on an airport. They you are dressed up here, they are aware about the airport and they will be handling long handling. And believe everybody has learned whatever sir has told you right from the beginning till end. So I have very big hope that you all will, you know, make my dream come true, that everybody will be having a job in hand to experience. And I know that sir has even given a clear picture. It's not completely a rosy picture that you go there and have all a glamorous lifestyle. So any job, you people know there's difficulty and hard work which is mandatory.
International fulfills your aim.
AIMFIL International, Institute of Job Oriented Training.